Welcome, welcome, welcome. Hope everybody's having a good day. Hope everybody's having a great, great day. How are we doing tonight? Everybody having a good night? Everybody having a good evening? A good day overall, I hope? Alrighty. Well, welcome. I'm Jaliski. We're going to be running tonight some Pokemon XY for y'all. We're going to be doing some Ultimate Ironmon, so it's a little different than what we have been doing here, which has been some Fire Red, Leaf Green fun and having a good time with that. But I felt, you know, there's not a lot of love out there for XY, and I said, hey, I loved XY. XY, to me, was, it was the gen that got me back into Pokemon. So I played a lot of 1, a lot of Gen 2. I played a good bit of Gen 3. I played through much of Fire Red, or I had Leaf Green at the time. That's why I run Leaf Green. Just in the really in the randomizer, there's literally no difference between the two. It's just it's a nostalgia thing. It's a nostalgia thing. And unfortunately, I never got to play much of 4 or 5, Gens 4 or Gens 5. And then I got back into it in Gen 6 when I got my 3DS. So I was very happy to jump into Gen 6. Gen 6 was a lot of fun. Like, you know, Gen 6 is the, you know, it's kind of the progenitor, the first one of the modern gens. Introduced a lot of modern conveniences, modern ideas into, you know, the whole Pokemon series. And that is something that, you know, is important, you know, when we get down to it. There's a lot that we can look at and a lot that we can do when we're looking at these newer gens and we're thinking about these newer ideas like this. So that's really where I'm going for this particular run here. Is I'm gonna have a lot of fun just playing it. I've never seen anybody actually run a XY Ironmon or even Ultimate Ironmon. I've run Ultimate Ironmons on, you know, not streamed, but I've run them, you know, personally a couple times before. And, you know, really enjoyed them. I'm going to need a little bit of refreshing, taking out the Kaizo part and pulling in, you know, just the ultimate part. Yeah, dealing with that fun stuff. But I'm really looking forward to this. I think it's going to be a blast. I think we're going to have a lot of fun with this particular challenge. So these first couple nights here are going to be a lot of testing, making sure that everything's working okay, making sure that, you know, we understand kind of the basic setups and how all this stuff sort of runs. So I'm really looking forward to it. I think it's going to be really interesting, really fun. And yeah, that's where we're going to go with this. So I have a couple of good number of hours tonight to stream, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and get some streaming in on this XY and see how it runs. Like I said, it's going to take a little bit of time for me just kind of get into the groove of everything. You know, I've been playing the Kaizo Ironmon just with keyboard. Now I have, you know, actual controller, you know, that of course is important in the modern Pokemons like that, that you are running with the controller. So it's going to be different. It's legit going to be different. So, but I'm looking forward to it. I'm really going to enjoy this, I think. So we are going to be doing some Ironmoning in that particular sense, some ultimate Ironmoning. So for those of you familiar with the stats, there's going to be slightly different stats set up for this. I'm fairly certain I got what I want out of this. If not, I'll go back and change the stat sheet. as needed along the way. But for the most part, I think I'm ready. I think I'm ready and set to go here. Let me just double check everything real quick before I get too deep in. And don't want to get everything squared away properly. So I think I got it all, which means that we should be ready to go. So hopefully we'll get a run or two good ones out of this tonight. We'll see how it goes. I've only run just some little test runs on this in the past. So this is very new. This is something that I'm a little anxious about, but I'm also really kind of excited about. I think it's going to be a lot of fun to get in there and just try this out. You know, I've heard horror stories. I've read horror stories about, you know, Ironmons in XY and in Gen 6 and Gen 7s in particular, that they can be really freaking difficult. I'm looking forward to it because, you know, it's to me, this is potentially just going to be a lot of fun. So, all right, are we ready? I think I've set everything up. I think everybody's good with how we're going on this. So let's go ahead and get going then, shall we? All right, so first things first, we're going to, one of the important things in XY running is that you need to make your choice before you get to see the particular things. It's not like the lab in Fire Red, Leaf Green, where you get the three balls and their mystery on that particular scent. In XY, the moment you see those three balls, you see the three mons that are inside. So you have to make your choice before you get to that point in the game. Additionally, I will be running the intro at 3x speed, just because it is a longish intro, as many of these modern Pokemon games tend to have. They tend to have these longish sort of intros associated with them. So I'm going to run it at triple speed just to get things moving a little bit faster. I may toggle that on and off as needed, particularly during, things like searching sessions in the grass and that sort of stuff. So that's what's going to happen here. But I think we are ready. Let's get going. So we're going to be starting off with a mid run here. We're going to be starting off with that middle run in this particular setup. All right, let's do this. There we go. Like I said, getting everything ready. It's the fun part about the whole thing. All right. Looks like it is working. Fantastic. Got everything up and ready. Oh, yeah. There we go. That looks gorgeous. All right. Let's do this, shall we? All right. All right. Sorry about that. I was just trying to get everything squared away. I hope the sound on everybody's side sounds good. All right, we're going to go with Terrence. Fun part about this is because it's touchscreen, I can use the mouse. It makes entering these very easy, even at high speeds. Alrighty, let's get going. So even on my good computer here running this in emulation, it still slows down a little bit here and there. But you can see I am definitely cruising. All right. Mom says hi, and we go out and meet R2. Happy pseudo rivals. One actual rival, one just the neighbor that's along for the ride who we'll see all over the place. So in this case, that would be Serena and Shauna. And of course, our pet, Rhyhorn, who we get to sit on. All right. Now we meet the crew. And we get to choose which of these terrible nicknames we want to be. We're just going to be a little T. All right. Here we go. So we are a team mid. That means we are going to be running. Well, we can't run it. I would love to be running a Latias, but we cannot run a Latias. So we have to choose between either a Dragalga All right, I'm going to have to check my stuff here, but we're definitely not going middle. I'm definitely not going to take a Chikorita against a Latias, so I think we're going to take that Dragalga. Now, the interesting thing in XY is that your primary rival, which is going to be Shauna, the little brown-haired girl there, she's going to be the one running the one to the left of us, which in this case would be the right ball, the Chikorita. We will have to go up against Serena at some point, and she will have the Latias, but for the most part, the first battle, the first bunch of rival battles will be going up against poor little Shauna here. So, all right, we're going to go ahead and give it a name. So I'm just going to name you Shrimpy. All right. Now, unfortunately, the randomizer has not quite gotten the text entirely in here appropriately, so we'll still see references to the actual original starters every once in a while. It's just the way it is. Can't really do much about that. And I just realized I hadn't updated this with run number one. That's right, run number one. We are on run number one. All right, so now we're supposed to go talk to Mom to get permission to go on our trip here. But first, we're going to take a peek at what Shrimpy knows and what Shrimpy's all about. So Shrimpy is a tank. It's a slow tank. Decent attack stat on this one. Let's go ahead, get a little more information about this. Let's see here, so Dragalga. So Dragalga is a nearly 500 BST dragon poison type, learns a lot of moves, which is going to be really useful through this. So let's go ahead, take a peek at these moves here. All right, so we got Tickle, Captivate, Water Pledge, which is a special move, and Brick Break, a physical move. I'm kind of fine with both of these moves. They're good moves. Captivate and Tickle, not so much, but could be worse. Could be worse. So I'm going to move that Brick Break up and move that Water Pledge up. There we go. Looks good. All right. So I'd say we have at least a shot. We have a lot of hit points for what we are here, but not like an insane number of hit points ultimately at the end of the day. All right. Now, technically, we can run down and grab a potion before this battle. I don't really think that that fits within kind of the classic Ironmon, you know, sort of philosophy, ultimately, at the end of the day. So I'm going to say I'm not going to go take that potion, even though it is free for at least a little while here. If we're not getting out of the lab as often, or not getting beaten our rival here first as often as we might like, then I may switch up and see if that's worthwhile for us to do. So, all right, so we're going up against Chikorita, basic grass type. The water move is not going to be particularly useful here, so I'm going to stick with Brick Break and hope that that's good enough. If Brick Break does almost literally nothing, then we may switch over to Tickling until it does. All right, Chikorita is going to wrap us up. That did some damage. I wouldn't say a lot of damage, but it did do some. I think a tickle is going to be worth it here. So let's go ahead and... Oop, well, that's a blaze kick. All right, luckily we are pretty tanky, so we can kind of handle that. All right, that wrap is going to get really annoying, but now we should be able to Brick Break for at least a little bit more. That looks a lot better. Two more Brick Breaks and we should be able to get out. Electroweb, that's going to hurt. Oh, wait, no, that's right. We are resistant to electric. I keep thinking that this guy is actually water. He's actually dragon poison, so. All right, this last Brick Break should be enough. We are going to just barely squeak by here. Fantastic. We are out, as we should be, with a Dragalga versus a... versus a Chikorita. So, all right, we're only going to be level 6, but that's all right. We're not in Kaizo, so we can still catch anything that we want. All right, she gives me, of course, that free heal, and now we can go back and say hello to Mom. Tell her the bad news that we're going out on an adventure. We're not staying here at home. All right, hurry for the town map. Yes, I know how to use a town map. All right, let's go ahead and get that out of the way, so that way then we can just watch our Dragalga fly about the screen. Now our little happy Fryhorn friend is going to come over and say goodbye. It's almost sad. It's almost sad. Mom's going to be like, aww. All right, sorry about this. Just trying to get everything up. There's a lot for me to handle on this, so. All right, so we get a free potion. Hi, you. Come on, come on, come on. I just want to talk to you. Let me talk to you. All right, we got a free potion. All right, we can go and pick up more balls over there, and we can pick up some additional potions if we want. So this is where I need to remember all of the beautiful rules when it comes to Ultimate Ironmon and all of that beautiful stuff. So we cannot pick up any items other than what we get through the game. So other than Pokeballs and, of course, your pals. All right. Run across the bridge. And there is a guaranteed spawn here no matter what. It's going to be our first one that we see. Spinda, I don't care about you, Spinda. All right, now we go through our catching tutorial. I'm going to go ahead and speed through this a little bit. Alrighty, so now we search. So I'm not going to get too deep into Route 2 here. That's a Mega Alakazam. Okay then, that is a Mega Alakazam. It is at level 5, so it could be either a 5 or a 6. No, it's Rage Powder, okay. I am definitely going to want to catch one of those, because that seems fantastic. That's a Mega Houndoom. All right, this game is just absolutely crushing us with good mons to start here. Wow. All right, so we got a Mega Houndoom okay. And it is at level 6, so if we can't find the Mega Alakazam at level 6, I say we go for that Mega Houndoom at level 6. All right, we got some snow. All right, some of these are not in the documents here, so. All right. Mega Houndoom, as you see, learns a decent number of moves along the way. Good BST of 600. All right, give me a level 6, and I'll take the Alakazam, I think, over the Houndoom. Ooh, no, it's facade. Not a bad move. All right, I'm going to run back. Now, the only problem in here, let's see here. So we can heal at this spot here. All right. Still want to see if that Alakazam is floating about in here. We know the Houndoom. So there are 6 different mons in this particular region in Route 2. So remember, in Ultimate Ironmon, the basic rule is that you can catch or kill one. It's very much like a Nuzlocke in that particular sense, but you get to choose which one that you're going to capture or kill along the way. So the hope here is that I will be able to just go ahead and capture that Alakazam. All right, I'm going to speed this up here a little bit. Right, punishment. Other reason I don't really want to deal with the Houndoom is that it appears to have snow, and I don't want to deal with it constantly doing damage to itself. That just seems like a really, really bad idea. All right, I want to see Mega Alakazam at level 6. Give me level 6. That is level 3. That means the Alakazam is either 3 or 5. Okay, it is what it is. I think I'd still rather take the Alakazam at 5 than the Houndoom at 6, just given what we saw. All right, we got a Bidoof here. All right, I feel normal. This feels normal. Houndoom is fast. That's something I'm going to have to give it in that respect. Granted, we are not fast, but at least our Dragalga isn't. Another Phoebus. And another Bidoof. And the sixth one in here is a Whimsicott. So the toughest part about this challenge ultimately for XY also is that there are often a lot of Mons. Oh, Glammeow. All right. That was number 6. Okay, sorry. There are a lot of Mons in these particular bushes. So, you know, when we get down to trying to figure out which one we want to fight and that kind of stuff. Oh, Bidoof is fast. When we're trying to figure out which one we want to fight and stuff like that, that's going to make this a little more interesting for us. All right. If we do find a Mega Houndoom at level 6 that doesn't have... All right, we found a 5. All right, let's go with this one. Cool. All right, we got the second one of our group here. All right, and we got ourselves Alakazam. All right, Mega Alakazam. All right, we are going to give you a nickname. I'm going to go with Lester. He feels like a Lester to me. All right, Lester. What do you know? All right. That is a lot of hit points for him, but not a absolutely insane amount. All righty. He is interesting, but not great. So Rage Powder, pretty much useless. Facade is good. Heal Order, it's not bad. And Magical Leaf, of course, is really good also. We do have kind of a balanced attack and special attack ultimately. So it's not bad. It's definitely a mon with some possibilities, we'll put it that way. I don't like the low special defense and the fact that our nature seems to take it down a little bit there, but okay, I've seen worse. Legit seen worse. I think it's worth a run. We'll just put it that way. I think it's worth a good run here, I'd say. We can definitely kind of play with it from here and see where it goes, because Mega Alakazam is going to be a pretty high BST mon for us to work with. So I think that's going to be our play here. We're going to go ahead and move him to the front. All right, we are going to have a pretty tough battle here on the first trainer. So there's a trainer right here through Route 2. Ready and waiting for us here at the end of Route 2. So he has one level 8 mon. All right, this one's a Drifblim. That's going to be a bit of a problem for us. All right, Facade isn't going to hurt it, so we'll Magical Leaf. It's going to use Conversion. It's Water type. Cool by me. Wasn't very nice. That was definitely not very nice. All right, well, there goes our Mega Alakazam. Looks like we're running Shrimpy. All right, Brick Break doesn't do anything. Water Pledge is the only thing that's going to do anything here. We could Captivate, I suppose. Being everything that we did see, I think there was Special Attack, so. Go ahead and do it again. Just keep dropping its special attack. All right, that should be good. Let's go ahead and just go ahead and Water Pledge it. Not a lot of damage. But we don't really have a lot of choices here. Oh wait, it transformed into water type, so we could actually just Brick Break it now. Feels weird doing that to, you know, ghost type, but conversion's a thing. Alright, he's just going to keep up in his speed. Alright. All right, only trainer here. Not a big fan of this Mon. It's too tanky. Heat Crash. Heat Crash. All right. So Heat Crash, for those of you not familiar with it, it is essentially a power move dealt with by outweighing targets, essentially. So you have to outweigh your target a pretty significant amount. It is a physical move, at least in that particular sense. Likely better than one of these two. I'm going to say it's likely better than at least Tickle. So it'll be useful when we go up against, you know, some... when we go against some smaller Mons. But for the most part, eh. All right, so we'll want to the forest, unfortunately, does not have high-level Mons. The highest-level Mons that it will have will be level 6. All right, we get at least a free healer along the way here. So let's see what we get floating about here. We got a spooky plate. How spooky. All right, we got the Trash Wormadon, level 5. Oh, I should probably heal up. We'll get to the ball here first. Cell Battery, okay. So one of the problems, ultimately, that you're going to see a lot with Ironmon in this particular gen is that there are so many items. Lumbre, all right. So there are 8 total Pokemon, by the way, in the forest here. But there are so many items floating about in the game that finding healing items can sometimes be a bit of a pain. All right, so they're going to battle. We're going to get our Paralyze heal, at least freebie from here. So everybody's settling in. All right, we can't avoid this first trainer, but I just... Let's go ahead and scan through what we got here in the forest, so... So I'm going to go ahead and get us on turbo mode here. Whoops, I just realized I was supposed to release Lester, so. Let's see here. All right, we're going to move him out of the front spot here. I can't really get rid of him right now. I just realized I also had to set that to that. All right. All right. All right, Durant, pretty much useless. It is faster than us, but we are not really all that fast at level 10, so. All right, nothing too special in here yet. Stop slapping me. Alright, all we're seeing are Wormadon, Lombre, and Durant at this point. Gotta be something better in these bushes, right? Alright, Mandibuzz is interesting. The only problem is that it's either 3 or 5. I don't know if I'd really call it necessarily a good one. It's not bad. It has a good BST ultimately on it. It's definitely one that we'll want to fight, I'd say. It learns a lot of moves, as most of them in XY tend to do. Something to keep in mind. Mandibuzz is not a bad choice. Bulbasaur is, however, a bad choice. All right, let's go down to these corner bushes down here. Got a Jellicent. All right, Jellicent. All right, let me look it up in here. Jellicent, 480 Water Ghost. Another Wormadam. Thus far, the Mandibuzz seems like the best option. Unfortunately, it looks like it might be only a level 3. Wow, it is really stupid fast. And it has a good Ice Beam. Wow, that did a lot of damage to me. Alright, I'm liking that Mandibuzz. If it's a level 5, I'm really willing to take it. Celio. Alright, only level 3. Floetta. No wonder. I'm using the wrong commands here. Wrong commands for things. Sorry, I have the two different bots floating about. There we go. There's Floetta and Jellicent. So Floetta, 371 BST. Effectively garbage. No, it's hyperspace hole though. That's a pretty good move. Alright, there's a level 5 Mandibuzz. Alright, we're gonna... Even though this isn't gonna work, I just want to see what moves it knows. Knows Hypnosis. Okay. Relic Song. Didn't do a lot. I did like the Ice Beam that it had. It did do a decent bit of damage before. We know it is fast. It is going to learn some good. It is going to learn some moves. Only problem is we saw the ice beam at level 3. I don't know that it necessarily has it here at level 5. So meditate, hypnosis. All right, got the hypnosis off. That's fine. Relic song. Confuse Ray. Yeah, the Mandibuzz is junk at level 5. It lost Ice Beam, which is the only thing that it had going for it. So, I haven't seen anything else in these bushes that's worthwhile. So, I'm going to run from this. Oh, can't get away. All right. We're going to heal up and we're going to attack the level 5 Mandibuzz then. Unfortunately, I think that's the play that we're just going to have to make along here. Could also save the kill in here for... We could go over to Route 3. We could run through the forest, do Route 3. Only problem is that there are two trainers that we do have to do. Well, actually, only one. There's only one trainer that we have to do. So we could go run to Route 3 where we could find some 8s. That could be actually really useful. Yeah, let's do that. Let's see how that runs. Let's see how that runs. I'd much rather get a better Mon than our Shrimpy here. Before, you know, going too far and having a bad Mon, you know, having this kind of mad Mon, you know, do all the work, you know. If I can catch a level 8 something on Route 3, having only leaving 2 trainers here and then all the trainers on Route 3, I'd be perfectly happy with that, so... So I think that's what we're going to do. We're just going to go ahead and do that. So we'll grab this one trainer along the way here. Sorry, just reading something here. Hi, sorry about that. I was just checking something. Something popped up that I went, oh, gotta do that. Do I have any Pokeballs? Yes, I'll take another Pokeball. I will take a freebie Pokeball. All right, so this is the only required trainer that we have on this route. And it's just one Mon. Somehow we're faster than it, which I'm totally cool with. You're gonna heat crash me? Seems good. I will heat crash you. How's that sound? Ooh, we got the burn on me. That sucks. So Heat Crash is a physical move, so the burn is hurting me in that sense. So I'm going to go ahead and switch over to Water Pledge. All right, that did a little more damage than the heat. Did. All right, finish off you with Water Pledge. Alright, so we'll be sacrificing a little bit of levels to hopefully find a better level 8. That is the hope here. Don't put me to sleep. All right, Firestone. Get out of the forest and head on to Route 3, where hopefully we'll find a new, better Mon to actually run than this one. Now, the only problem is that we do lose Shauna as our freebie. Heal, so we're going to have to play this a little more carefully here. We can play in these bushes over here. Alright, so in these bushes, in the Route 3 bushes over here, we will have the potential of 5 different Mons at level 8. So Palpitoad is one of them. Palpitoad is not something I want to run. Alomomola. Pretty sure this is a lowish BST 470. Not really worth it. A lot of them seem to have gear grind. Oh, gear grind. Sorry, thought it was change gears. That's something completely different. It's fast. Feather Dance doesn't really do anything. All right, Masquerine, not really worth it either. Relicanth. Relicanth is interesting. Rock Water, moderate, decently high BST associated with it. It's okay. It's okay. I would definitely consider it. Lairon, definitely not. Did not like the fact that we did get away from that Relicanth rather easily. It does not bode well for its speed. Monferno? Alright, we're finding some interesting mons floating about in the bushes here. I'm feeling, I think, the Relicanth the most. Another Durant. And a Palpitoad. All right. We're going to speed this up here a little bit. All right. I'd like to see that Relicanth again, I think. Alright, let's see. I'd like to see that Relicanth again, please. And thank you. There we go. Level 8. Perfect. Sure, we'll throw the Cherish Ball at it. Defense Curl? Okay, that's fine. I'm going to go ahead and Captivate it. I want to see a little more. No Slash. All right. And Splash, appropriately enough. Okay, defense curl, that's fine. All right, what's your fourth move? We know you can splash. We know you have slash. All right, it's telling me essentially that It just doesn't know anything else that's worthwhile. Can't be used on me, most likely. Comet Punch. Okay, Comet Punch is okay. We have two normal moves with it. Cool. I was getting worried there. All right, Worry Seed. All right, so Worry Seed. No, Worry Seed's useless. All right, we got ourselves a Relicanth. Let's see here. I'm going to call him Quincy. All right, let's find out if Quincy is any good. He's good. He's legit good. He's definitely not bad. Once we get rid of some of these bad moves here, he could grow into this. He could definitely grow into this. We got Comet Punch and Slash, two nice normal moves, normal physical attack moves. Yeah, I'm totally okay with Quincy. Quincy, you're going to be our run. Get you up there and let's start leveling you up, shall we? All right, we got ourselves a Relicanth. All right, let's go back, grab those other trainers. And let's beat up on Amanda Buzz while we're at it. Hope we don't run into a ghost. If we run into a ghost, we are in trouble. All right. Good hit. The Zatu and the Natu. Very nice. Wow. That Natu has some defense. All right, you're going to protect. That's fine. All right, so Relicanth is going to learn its next move at 15. So it's one of these kind of slow learning mons. It learns pretty much every 7 levels up to 78. All right, Shiny Stone. All right, so we're looking for the level 5 Mandibuzz along the way here for the experience. We're also heading back to heal up. All right, Celio, not worth it. Durant. All Wormadam. All right, slash. Very nice. Tail slap ain't gonna do a whole heck of a lot. It is gonna hit five times though. Because of course. All right, Comet Punch. Kapow. That'll be a nice bit of experience for us. All right, Slurpuff, Fairy type. Go ahead and slash it. Pin Missile. Three. All right, you aren't going to get the five on me. That's important. All right, we'll slash again. Almost gotcha. Stun Spore, that's annoying. All right, switch over to Comet Punch. And there you go. Trainer down. Very even sort of spread, but kind of okay with it. All right, so now we should be able to avoid the grass here without too much issue. And of course, all the Route 2 stuff here. Cool, we got through that. Yeah, so the only problem, of course, with going through in this particular fashion, is that we do lose Shauna as that free heal. So we have to come all the way back here to heal. All right, we're going to speed this up here. Everybody settling in pretty nice tonight, I hope. We got ourselves a first try run, so that's kind of exciting. Kind of excited about this Relicanth. Definitely looks okay. I wouldn't call it the best thing I've ever seen, but you want to know what? It ain't half bad. Sometimes it's all you need. You just need something that ain't half bad. Alright, so we got everything here in the forest. Oh, there was a Tangrowth floating about in here? Oh, that makes me mad. That makes me a little sad. Tangrowth would have been an interesting mon. I don't really like running grass types in general. They're weaknesses. There's just too many of them. But, there are worse things in the world. Alright. So we got two required trainers before we get to the town here. So let's jump in, get them out of the way. All right, you got yourself a Jumpluff. Go ahead and slash that jump bluff. It's a dead jump bluff. A Boldore, this is going to be a problem for me. At least did some damage. Searing Shot shouldn't do a lot. Alright, it's going to take four slashes to get through this Boldore. It also knows Slash, but normal moves aren't that effective on us. Kind of sounds familiar, doesn't it, Boldore? Alright, four slashes, Boldore down. Alright, I'm not opposed to this Mon. This Mon has some good stats. The moves hopefully will find their way to us here. If we get a couple good, you know, one more good physical move here, I think we'll have a good shot. Ooh, Umbreon. I would love an Umbreon. Umbreon would be fantastic. Oop, that's alright. Trick or treat. Adding ghost type to me. It's not very nice. Alright, heat wave doesn't really matter. Finish you off with a slash. Level 13! That attack is going up nice. 34 attack at this point with 33 speed, good defenses. This is a good Mon. It's a legitimately good Mon. I'd be happy to have this one in pretty much any generation. Alright, Crazy Roller Skater. Alright, I think we're going to heal up first here. And then we'll come back. Come back, grab the items and the other two trainers here. Now we could try and see if there's something else floating about in Route 22. That is going to be our next possible route along the way here. Route 22 will have 8s, 9s, and 11s at it. So I'm definitely thinking I want to take a peek in there. We're not that high up with the Relicanth right now. And Relicanth is good, don't get me wrong. But I think it's worthwhile checking what those bushes have up there in Route 22 before we go through and do any more trainers here on Route 3. So, and we're also going to go ahead and deposit our Alakazam. Bye-bye. All right, how many, I should have checked this before, how many Pokeballs do we have left right now? We have 5? I should probably buy a couple more just to be safe. Just in case. We'll buy 8 more. Hopefully should be plenty. All right, let's go check what we got out here on Route 22. First, let's grab the secret items that are floating about out here. Before I forget about them. Richard. TP up. Okay, that's useful. Aranga berry. Okay. And then we can go into the trainer school real fast here. And grab us some X attacks and X defenses. All right, so there's one trainer before we can get to these bushes. She is level 9 and level 11 Mons, so we should be fine. Aggron is that's a problem for us. Aggron is a legit problem for us. I don't like doing this, but I'm fairly certain our Relicanth will not be able to do anything to that. Oh, goody. Okay. That's perfectly fine by me. You can levitate. I'm going to finish you off, and then I'm going to switch back over. I hate doing that, but we needed coverage. And normal moves against that guy, pretty much useless. So we are going to get the... All right, we're going to go ahead and brick break it first. That's fine. Sure. Turned into energy ball. Okay. Wow, that fiery dance. That smoke screen is doing work. Cool. All right, I'm going to switch over back to Quincy. It's fine. Good enough. Oof. Wants to learn curse. Curse. curse, curse, curse. Well, it is technically better than Splash. So, yeah, it is technically better than Splash. So we will go ahead and do that. All right, Quincy needed a better move at level 15. So, Diamond Storm. That is a really good move. Alright, so our shrimp has all the coverage that we'd ever want, and our fish, which has the best stats, has nothing. Cool. Alright, so we're going to zoom through here. That's a Rhyperior at level 8. If it's at level 8, unfortunately, we can only find it at level 9, but it is still one at level 8. Alright, let's go ahead and heal back up. I will gladly take Rhyperior. Rhyperior, fine Mon. Alright, so let's go ahead and take a peek at the Rhyperior stats. Rhyperior. So Rhyperior, not bad. A 535 BST. I don't like ground rock, but yeah, we'll see what else is in these bushes here. Avalug. All right, that's an Avalug at level 11. So Avalug. Pure Ice 514. Generally not going to run a pure ice mon. Combusken? Alright, Combusken's at 9. Means it could be 11 also. So there are, let's see here, there are 2 mons at 8 and 9, 2 mons at 9, 2 mons at 9 and 11. That's a Zoroark at 9. I would do a Zoroark. Zoroark learns a lot of moves. Dark type is perfectly fine. 510 BST. I'm kind of okay with that Zoroark. All right. Particularly if we can find a level 11 version on it, I'd be all okay with the Zoroark. Oshawott is a cute little baby junk. All right, so we found Rhyperior, Avalug, Zoroark, Combusken, Oshawott. That leaves 3 other mons floating about. Rhyperior is 8 and 9. That was Hurricane. All right, Avalug appears to be just level 11. Rhyperior is fast, by the way. Cubchoo, not so much. I don't know if I really trust it being that fast when we're already really fast with Quincy here at level 15 and it being faster than us at level 9. That's a little scary. I think it might just be all speed and nothing else is be the biggest problem I'd have with it. All right, Avalug is a 9-11. Buskin appears to be one of the only level 9s. Or level 9 onlys, I should call it. Alright, Zorak, only 9. Alright, we're still missing 2 Mons in the forest, or in the Route 22 here. Rhyperior with conversion 2? Yeah, definitely not interested in this Rhyperior. Right, Oshawott, 11. Cubchoo. Avalug. Alright, slow start is a bad ability. Alright, there should be 2 other Mons floating about in here. Oh, come on. Show me those other 2. Show me those other 2. Otherwise, I might just have to take this Relicant the whole way. I am not looking forward to that. Did not want to go that far. All right. Looks like we're doing this. Yeep. All right, we'll go ahead and brick break it. Clauncher, huh? Hyperspace hole. Okay. It's a move that does some damage. Alright, I was not expecting that to actually kill. Alright, let's see if there are other Mons floating about. The other Mons are floating about here. Shouldn't be the case, but sometimes you just need to swap things up a little bit. around. Run back and heal on up. All right. Definitely not that, Zoroark. Slow start, bad ability. There's one of the other ones. It's a Carvana. A little goth fish. Tentacool. All right. There are the last ones. So I think a Zoroark is only level 9. So if we find one that doesn't have slow start, then I think we'll take that one. I've always wanted to run a Zoroark. Sure, those ones that we couldn't find for how long there all of a sudden now start showing up. And the one thing that we're actually looking for, we can't actually get. Come on. All right, come on, Zoroark. Ouch. Stop. I have to admit, I'm also slightly tempted by the Avalug, but I do not want to run an ice type. Oh, come on. Like, seriously, folks. There you are. And you are not slow start. Perfect. All right, let's catch you. Sky drop. It's a fun little move. Didn't do a lot of damage, but it shouldn't do a lot of damage to me. Needle arm. I don't like protein, though. That did a lot of damage. Yeah, that did a lot of damage. That tells me that, that Zoroark, that Zoroark is a problem. That's what that tells me. The Zoroark is a problem. All right. I don't know if I like protein as an ability. With the Zoroark. It does make it interesting, but it also makes it really difficult. You know, it's still worth it, I think. It's still worth it to see. That needle arm taking up almost half my health. That's rough. Oh, come on. It's one of the biggest problems I have with the game is sometimes the talking to people can be a bit of a pain. All right, we're gonna swap these two around. Judging by what we know of this Zoroark that we're looking for here. That might be dangerous because we can't run from the other ones as easily with this one. So we'll swap them on the first turn before we start attacking. Or before we start trying to catch the Zoroark. All right, back to speed hacks. Nice thing is that we left a couple of those trainers there on Route 3. So because we left those trainers there on Route 3, we'll be able to go back and beat them with the Zoroark if it's any good. Assuming we ever find one again and don't die to it like almost immediately. Do 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 There we go. That's a slow starter. All right, we can't take a slow starter. For those of you curious about why we can't do that, well, it is on switch end, but that does include the first turn, if I remember correctly. Let me double check that just to make sure. First five turns of battle, so we don't want our attack and our speed to be lowered for five turns. That's generally a bad idea. I'd rather take protein. We can run around protein. Protein is interesting. Has some potential defensive uses. It has some strategy behind it that we could potentially use if we get a good stable of moves. Slow start is just bad. It's just a bad ability. All right, Zoroark, show up a little more often now. There we go. Slow start, of course. All right. Avalog, Avalog. Excalibur. From the United K. Sorry. Been watching Soul Leader. Again. Love that anime. It's silly and it's fun and it's just a good story. I've really enjoyed that one. When I said Avalog in that way, it just kind of made me think of the Excalibur song. Excalibur, Excalibur, Excalibur. Gotta do something to entertain yourself, right? While we go through a pivot or while we go through a catch grind here. Oh, all the Rhyperiors we ever want and more. All the Avalugs we ever want and more. But wait, there's more. I'm getting close to giving up on this Zoroark. Game very close. Now we're seeing all these little baby mons. Nothing but baby mons. Not even something like the Avalog that I'd like to fight. There's an Avalog. Yeah, it's level 11. Alright, am I just going to call it here? I think it's the right choice now. Cool. All right. Let's go fight those other trainers then down here in Route 3 with what we got. Aggron again? Jeez. I do not like Aggrons. I mean, that took 4 hits of slash with my level 16 mon to his level 5. Ugh, Aggron is tough. Alright, deep sea scale. Alright, then we'll take on her. Bronzor, huh? You know what? Get on in there, Shrimpy. You can grow me all you want. All right, so we got all the trainers on Route 3. Let's go back and heal back up here. All right, we're going to try and split as much of the experience as we possibly can along the way here. We'll wait with you for a little while. Let's go ahead and handle you. You got a girder. Okay, just casually throwing out a Mega Dragon. Cool. I love it when they just casually are like, do, 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 boom. Enjoy. Just realized I still had it on Mega Speed. Alright, so Relicanth. There's Relicanth. So Relicanth, we're going to be looking at level 22 for its next move. Do, 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 do. Slash. I'm slashing prices. And I'm slashing you. Quite truthfully, the stats on this thing are really good. If we could just get a decent move or two. One additional good move here would be fan-freaking-tastic. And something that isn't normal. A good fighting move would be fantastic. You know? Something that handles rock and steel. That would be très magnifique. Casually tossing out a shaman. Cool. Crush Claw. Cool. I'm fine with you using Crush Claw. Does pretty much nothing to me. Lava Plume? That is also not going to do a lot to me. All right, level 20. All right, that's all we can get on this particular route. We have gotten all of the trainers except for Awakening. That's a nice item. We have gotten all of the trainers except for Roller Skate Girl. So we will go handle Roller Skate Girl next. But first, let's heal up. All right, let's get us some roller skates, shall we? Crawdont, I wonder what we're going to do to it. We're going to slash it. Super Fang, that would have hurt. Finish you off with a little comet. Punchy. All right. And we got the roller skates. Now we can go zoom, zoom, zoom. Zoomity, zoomity, zoom. Woo! Gotta have fun while you can, right? Gotta have fun. All right. So I think we have gotten everything that we can at this point. We've gotten all the trainers. We've done all the things. That means, you know what time it is. It's gym time. Finally, we get gym time. Alrighty. So let's go ahead and take a peek at what we got in the bag. Let's see here. X attacks, and that we got PP up, awakening, paralyzed, heal. We got no TMs. We got a Moronga berry. Alrighty. Well then, we should give the deep sea scale to somebody. So we will go ahead and give it to Quincy. That is, of course, legal in Ironmon, particularly Ultimate Ironmon. It is perfectly okay to do that and perfectly expected. So that will give us a nice little boost to our special defense. So just as a quick reminder of what we got here with a Quincy. Quincy is a good attacker, not so good on the special attack, which is exactly what we like in that. Has good speed. It is sturdy. Which is, of course, really good in case we do get hit by that random grass move that's going to do 4x damage to us. So upping the special defense still seems like a good move ultimately at the end of the day. All right. Go ahead and give this a little save and let's go. Gym time. So the first gym, generally not too terribly difficult. So remember that in Ironmon or in Ultimate Ironmon rules, this is you have to complete everything in one shot, and you must take on all of the trainers in the gym. So actually, do we have to fight all of them? I believe you do. I'm just double checking, making sure. You must defeat all trainers and cannot leave until you get the badge. So yes, that is the classic setup there. All right, so first things first, let's go ahead and get this trainer. Now, unfortunately, we only have a potion to our name at this point, so we're hoping for the best. Execute. Slash away. All right, transform to normal, that's fine. Automatize, definitely not bad. All right, we're still faster than it, which is a good sign. So execute down. And first one. All right, so the first one is done. And we have the one on the left over here. Follow the drops. All right, this one also has just a single level 15. It is a Mighty Inna. All right, we will slash it. That did not do a lot of damage. Bone Rush is going to do some damage to us, though. Ouch. Ouch. Stop it. Why'd you get the full five? Jerk. I'm going to switch over to Shrimpy. Shrimpy at least has the fighting move that's going to help here. Bone Rush will hurt. You gonna get another five on us? Okay, no, you didn't. You got a three. Good. All right, Petal Blizzard shouldn't hurt too bad. And this should finish off Mightyena. All right. I'm gonna get some good experience for both of them. All right, Quincy up to 21. We're going to need him up to 22 soon. Okay, casual rage Gigas. Seems fair. All right, that did a decent amount of damage. Ghost type, fantastic. We can't actually do any damage to it when it's ghost type. All right, hail, that's annoying. All right, we don't have anything super effective against ghost type, but let's go ahead with the Diamond Storm. Muddy water, not going to do a lot of damage to us. And of course, it's going to hit our accuracy. Alright, that did not do enough damage. Kill it off, but it got close. So I'll finish it off with... let's just do a water pledge. Ground type? That's fine. You can be ground type. Totally cool with that. 100% cool with that. All right, Murkrow. Well, luckily we got some rock moves here, so... I am surprised that didn't kill it. Ice will, but... Alright, level 18 for Shrimpy. Not quite enough for our good mod. We got a 15 and 18 coming up here with Viola. I'm gonna play it safe. Play it safe. 18 is gonna be the tough one. All right, take a picture. We got this. Just don't throw out a gross type. All right, Wishcash, we can handle a Wishcash. Wishcash ain't bad. Slash it. Good hit. Light screen, that's not annoying because we're not attacking you on the special side. Comet Punch. Okay. Level 22, new move day. Be something good, be something good. Searing Shot. Okay, so those of you not familiar with Searing Shot, 100 power, special move. Can leave things with a burn. It is a good, good move. I will take it over Defense Girl. All right, second one is Tyrant. All right, this is a little annoying. Rock Dragon, we definitely don't want to use fire on it. I'm going to just see how much damage we can do with a slash, and then we'll go with it from there. Quick Attack, doesn't do a lot. That was even a crit? Wow, all right. Yeesh. This might take a while, folks. I think I'm going to curse myself. Get my attack and defense up. I have plenty of speed, so... Ice Fang? Not really a problem. Go ahead and keep cursing myself. It's fine. You can get your little quick attacks in. That's fine. All right, one more, and I think we should be fine. Swift. All right, let's go ahead and start slashing you here. There we go. That was a decent-ish bit of damage. Vice Grip, just not going to do a lot. You're attacking me all these physical attacks, and I have good defense. And we got the crit to win. Viola, congratulations. First ever run. And we go through and beat Viola. Pretty fantastic. Good for us. Go ahead and update those stats. We got our very first run through Viola. Memento. Yeah, that's not exactly a TM I want. All righty. Well, there you go. And first gym complete. All right, let's go heal. All right, double checking just to make sure that we did not leave anything in here, and we are good. All right, let's go to Route 4. So Route 4 is kind of where everything gets going here. So first things first, we got to make sure that once we get into Route 4 here, so we're going to get the experience share item right away here at the beginning of Route 4 from our little reporter friend here. That's fine. But we got to do one thing before we do anything with that. We got to turn off that experience share. Alrighty, so let's do this. So there are two types of flowers here, yellow and red. Those are our grasses. Each of them have different sets of mons. Those mons are going to be at 9, 11, or 12, mostly at 12. We have yellow and red flowers here. So let's go ahead and take a peek at what we got. See if there's anything good here. All right, Hooptar, Slacketh, Melodic. That's a Melodic. Like, legit Melodic. So Melodic should learn a lot of... should learn a lot of moves along the way here. It's about to learn one at 13. Has a high BST, water type, of course, generally a goodish typing. Okay, we got a Melodic. Likely not to be much better in here, but it's worth a peek. Nidoking. Definitely don't want to run Nidoking. All right, I'm going to go up to the red flowers here. Oh, first we're going to see what else is here. Another Nidoking. All right, let's check the red flowers. See what's up here in the red. Wingull. Salamence. Ooh. Salamence. Okay. I kind of like a Salamence. Salamence is kind of happy. Let's find a level 12 Salamence and see what's up with that. So Salamence, 600 Dragon Flying BST, learns a crud ton of moves along the way. And all mons in these bushes should have a level 12 version. So I'm definitely loving the Salamence. Totally worth it to go for a level 12 Salamence here, I think. Double 12. Perfect. Doom Desire. Okay. Okay, we got ourselves a Salamence. All right, that's number four of their six that we can catch, but it's hard to complain about a Salamence, you know? All right, let's see what he's like, or what she's like. Don't like the low defense, but in general, Salamence only has the weakness to ice. There aren't a lot of ice physical moves. We do have the weakness to rock and dragon, which can be. What are the moves? We got ourselves a Doom Desire. Okay. Fusion Flare, which we've seen before. Wonder Room. And Absorb. Absorb is an interesting one here. All of these, unfortunately, are special attacks as it's set up here. Little sad in that particular sense, but this is a perfectly reasonable Mon, I think, for us to run. I think it's better than, and it has Magic Bounce as its ability. Reflex status moves. That's pretty sexy, to say the least. That is a legitimately sexy ability. All right. Now the question becomes, is this better than what we got with our Relicanth. Relicanth has a really good stat spread. This is not bad. Like, the defense is a little low. I don't like the fact that all our moves are currently special attacks, but it's not like our special attack is terrible. We have good coverage of those special attacks, so yeah, I think it's worthwhile. I think it's worth a I think it's definitely worth it. Nope, I just wanted to, particularly because we just don't have the moves with Quincy yet. Nah. There we go. We just don't have the moves with Quincy, so I'm kind of on him ultimately at the end of the day. So. All right, let's go ahead and train up here then. So, let's see here. Most of these are going to be level 15s along through here. So let's go ahead and pick up a lot of these items first. So we got that there. Mushroom. Got ourselves a hidden item down here. Chesto Berry. That's a good item. Run by him. Burn Drive. All right, time to see how this Salamence holds up. Ponyard. All right. Totally cool with that. We got a effective move against him. Oh no! Oh no! We got owned. All right, looks like we're setting up Doom Desires and Throne Don't Absorbs until then. that's terrible. It's hilarious and terrible. All right, this might take a while, folks. Settle on in. We're going to ping him down a couple points at a time and hope that his confusion Alright, tempered Doom Desire! Alright, that actually did some damage. Set up the next Doom Desire. Hope that he hits himself. He did not. Doing a point of damage at a time with that absorb. Hit yourself. That actually did a point, did an actual tick of damage on its bar. Alright, time to swap you out. Quincy, get on in there. Oh, can't be, that's right. I forgot about that. Not until the clamp gets out of the way. We might be losing Petunia here. Alright, we do have an extra potion. Don't want to lose them right away, so I'm going to go ahead and use it. It is only a potion, after all. It's not like it's anything really... set up a next Doom Desire then. And I think Petunia is dead. Yep. Well, it was nice knowing you, Salamance. You gave it your best, but what can you do about a flash fire, Ponyard? Not a whole heck of a lot. Not a whole heck of a lot. Wow. I now wish I hadn't gone for that Salamence. That's a Mega Gyarados just hovering around in the red flowers. Just casually sitting there. Like, hey guys, you wanna know what? You could've had me. Could've had me. Alright, well, unfortunately, Petunia did die. So, Petunia, sad to say, goodbye. Okie dokie. Full restore, fantastic item. Gotta admit, I'm really curious. Yellow flute. If that Mega Gyarados is actually going to be any good or not. Gotta admit, I'm slightly curious. But we'll have to wait. Find out later, I guess. Oh, come on. I need to go pick up some repels. Alright, so we got the two skaters floating about here, both of level 15s. And go Mega Binet. Alright. And we got a Syrian shot. And we got the burn. Fantastic. You can stockpile all you want. Totally cool with that. Go ahead and continue serene shotting. Bone rush is gonna hurt. No, not as much as before. That's good. I can take 4 points of damage. 4 points of damage, that's not bad. It's nice having a move that we can actually hit ghosts with. When all we had were normal moves, that was a problem. Alright, Mega Binet down. All right, what do you got for us? What's your level 15er? Tortuga. Go ahead and slash him. Little baby turtle. Makes me sad. Ouch. Petal Dance is gonna hurt. That hurt a lot. You made me do that. All right, let's head on back, get healed back up, because that hurt a lot. A lot, a lot. All right, let's see here. We got... Oh, sorry, it's up here. Red flute, useless. All right, you got a whole bunch of 11s. Shouldn't be too hard. Everybody chilling out there tonight, enjoying, I hope. Meganium. All right. Good time as any to give you a little fire. Do appreciate the additional coverage. Alright, Palpitoad. Water ground. Just go ahead and slash it. Right, Mach Punch. Luckily did not do a lot. This trainer does have that random super potion. All right, Panseer shouldn't be too hard. Go ahead and slash that. And down it goes. All right, go up, grab this item here. Shell Bell, yes, please. Oh, yes, 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 and yes. Oh, please and thank you. Please and thank you for that. All right, that makes things a lot more interesting for us here. All right, let's take on the little girl here, has level 14. Casually tossing out a Charizard. I'm cool with that. I'm gonna slash that Charizard. That did not do a lot of damage. But you want to know what? I'm okay with that. Alright, well, it looks like we're in for a long battle here. Okay. I see how this is going to go. So, I'm going to sit back. I'm just going to curse myself for a little bit here. Aeroblast ain't going to be too bad. Go ahead and curse again. Another Aeroblast, that's fine. Let's get another curse in there. Sure. You're doing nothing here. Alright, now let's slash you, Hobbit. How's that sound? All those attacks you put on me during this time did nothing. I'm liking this Mon now. I really am. Alright, kiddo. He just traded for a cool Pokemon. Show it off, show it off. Oh my god, it is cool. It's a Whimsicott. It's so cool. You like my rockfish? My rockfish that knows fire. Oh, it didn't kill it? What? How did that not kill it? Don't you dare poison me. Don't you dare poison me. Alright, we're going to finish you off with a slash. Gotta have fun while you're playing, right? That's the whole point of playing games in the first point. Right? Have some fun. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and get this guy. He has a level 15. Galvantula. Galvantula. Sorry. It's a bug. Burn it. Burn it with fire. I did burn it. Quite literally, I burnt it. Okay, then. That was mean. That was very mean. Not a big fan. Not a big fan at all. Ooh, an Esper Berry. Alright, very nice. Grab this item here, some safety goggles. The goggles, they do nothing. Alright, we're going to run back and heal up. Alright, we don't have a lot of trainers left here. We got the one up here in the Northwest Gardens. Who's guarding this item? That's a Golurk. Okay. We'll see how much the Searing Shot does, but it is ground type, so it's going to resist it. I mean, okay. Moonstone. All right, so you're done, and next it's you. Two level 11s. Starting off with a little Slurpuff. Slash away. Mystical Fire. It's a good move. Except when you go up against a rock water type. Alright, I can't slash anymore. Guess I'll have to use my other moves. Politoed. We'll go with the Comet Punch. Oh no, I had to use other moves. Oh, almost a level up. Almost a level up there. Alright, so that should be everybody. I think I got all of the items. And that's it. Alrighty. And now we get these two. I meant to say yes there. Bone Club? Bone Club's a good move. My Relicanth almost wants to learn Bone Club. Let's see if my Relicanth can learn Bone Club. My Relicanth can learn Bone Club. Alright, double checking to make sure I can learn whatever TM I want. I sure as heck can. The TM restriction is, in fact, only in Kaizo. So, lowish accuracy, but you want to know what? I do like a curse. I do like a Comet Punch. I'm actually going to keep curse for now. Comet Punch is essentially slash. It's slash 2.0. I'd much rather have something that gives me better coverage in that sense. So I'm going to go ahead and switch over to Bone Club. I think that's going to be a better move for us. And welcome to Lumiose City. All right, so we got plenty of things to go and grab. Most of this stuff is set as to what it actually is. All right, so head over toward the lab. They'll tell us, hey, this is the lab. That's great. But I'm going to go first to the Pokemon Center and heal up before we go into our Professor Sycamore battle. and get our fifth mon. All right, and then let's see here. Let's go into the VR studio. Grab the lenses case. From her. And then the building next. Oh, I can't go that way yet. So we'll have to go do the lab next. So let's do the lab. All right, we're going to go to the second floor here real fast. We're going to grab some luxury balls. Why? Because we can. That way then I don't have to come back here and do that later. And then we're going to go up and beat on Professor Sycamore's mons, whatever three he happens to have. And we're going to be able to choose one of those three. So hopefully something that we can beat. And more importantly, something that we want. All right, let's do this, sir. Umbrella. All right. Grass fighting type. And we all know what we do to grass. Burn it. Well then. I guess we don't burn it. Okay then. Guess we're just gonna slash it. Flame Wheel isn't gonna do anything to us. Okay then. Not burning it. Level 26. Cricketot. What do we do to bugs? We burn them. And Fione. He's just going to casually toss out a Fione. All right. We'll slash it. Putting out a substitute. All right. That's a thing. We'll slash through that substitute. Rock Wrecker. Well, that's gonna do some damage. Not a lot, though. Do another slash, and that'll finish off Fione, which unfortunately we cannot grab the Fione. I would love to, but we cannot. Oh, that's right. The three here are different than the three that we fight. So, Swadloon, Snivy, or Vileplume. Well, Vileplume it is. Vileplume is likely just getting binned. I have decided that is, in fact, trash. All right, well, let's see how bad trash, in fact, is. Unfortunately, it does come in at level 10. Wow, that is bad. That is a bad mon. I'm disappointed that we have to use up one of our slots on this very, very disappointing, very disappointing mon. All right. Well, that is what it is. So now we can go pick up the rest of the random items around here and go and collect us. Go and collect us some additional experiences at the restaurant. All right, we wander in here. We get a little cutscene. Alrighty. Go skating down the avenue. Let's go heal up. And let's go pick up some more items. All right, I'm gonna grab a couple great balls here, just in case we have one more good catch that we want to do along the way here. And then a crud ton of repels. So we only got one more catch to go here, so we want to make sure that it is something good, something really, really good. Of course, we're going to be pretty high level pretty soon here, so. All right, this is Restaurant Luna. All right. Time to get some experience. I'd like to dine. The double battle meal. Oops, no, actually I will not. I forgot to save $3,000. back to the Pokemon Center, selling off a bunch of stuff. Luckily, we got plenty of stuff that we can't really use, so yeah, that'll work out. We made enough money. And we're about to make a whole bunch more. And gain a whole bunch of experience. Which is pretty darn fantastic. Oop, right here. Come on, get in there. All right, now I have enough money. Let's do this double battle meal. So we got three double battles. All right, we got a Scraggy and Dusclops. Versus our Quincy and Shrimpy. All right. Dusclops. We'll go ahead and Bone Club you. And then I'm going to Brick Break the Scraggy. I'm going to try a Searing Shot. And then we will do a Diamond Storm. So, sorry, partner. But luckily, it doesn't hurt you that bad. Finish you off with some rocks. Some very, very hard rocks. All right, first one down. All right, time for the second. What do we got for the second? Panpour and Blissey. Alright, this is going to be a little more interesting for us, I think. Let's just focus on the Blissey. All right, Blissey down. It's going to get us a lot of experience, which is a good thing. I don't like the fact that our special defense is not rising as fast as it was before for Quincy, but Fury Swipes? Yeah, no. All Okay, good. That didn't do a lot. I'll go ahead and slash the pan pour. And brick break it. More than enough. Good to know. Let's heal back some of that. All right, level 21. All right, second one done, third one coming. Abomasnow and Wormadon. And it's the trash Wormadon. That's a mega Abomasnow. That has pressure. Let's see here. Fire, fighting, rock, and steel. I guess Diamond Storm it is. It's nice having these dual or multi-hit moves floating about now. Makes these double battles a little easier. All right, Quincy is one move away from new move day. Shrimpy will be a good doubles partner. That's what I'm kind of, it's kind of what I'm feeling with Quincy at this point, or Shrimpy, I should say. Shrimpy definitely feels like a good doubles partner. Fourteen tiny mushrooms. That's going to be a lot of money. Sure, there you go. You can have a little tip. All right, fantastic. Let's heal back up. Alrighty, I think we got everything on this route as it is. We got that. Oh, no, we did not get all of the items. Let's see here. Trying to remember, is it this building? Yep. Quick Claw. And then on the second floor, we can get some more balls from these two guys. All right. And that seems like a good enough place to stop. So I'm going to get the holo clip here as we jump out to Route 5. And that is where we are going to stop for the night. So we got two interesting mons to play with here. Quincy is kind of coming into his own finally here. We got some decent moves. Good ability for the most part here. Good stats. That's a great stat spread ultimately at the end of the day for us. Tough to complain about that. And then Shrimpy as our doubles partner. Covers a lot of bases with a lot of good abilities. Doesn't have strong attack stats, but is a tank. Is a very good tank, and that's what you want in a doubles partner, is somebody just to absorb a whole bunch of hits for you and throw in some additional help here and there along the way. So definitely looking good. All right. Well, thank you again for taking a watch and enjoying the time here. It's been a lot of fun. You know, we made a lot of progress just on our first run. I mean, I was 100% was not expecting to come out with the first run and just absolutely crush it. We're having a really good run here on the first run. So, you know. Hey, how can you complain? We got a good first run. So, alrighty. Well, like I said, that's going to do it for me tonight. We'll see when I get to this next, but I'm definitely enjoying this. This is a lot of fun. This has been a blast, quite truthfully, for me. So, yeah. This should be a good time. Should be a good time. Alrighty. Well, thank you again. And I want you to be safe, be healthy, be wise, and we'll see you next time I stream. All right. Have a good night, y'all.